Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.
Good morning and welcome to Beyond Breast Cancer, another episode here with BCTV. We are excited to be here. My name is Raquel Capellan. I'm the program coordinator at Breast Cancer Support Services, and I'm really excited to be here today with Nina Rowley, our board member. So Nina, go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi. I'm Nina Rowley, and I'm a member of the board for Breast Cancer Support Services. I'm also a breast cancer survivor. In August, it will be 7 years, and I got so much out of BCSS, which is what led me to volunteer here and then become a board member. So I'm very pleased to be here and spend time with you today.
Thank you so much, Nina. Happy to be here with you. So, a little bit about BCSS. So BCSS, as we know already, is a survivor-driven nonprofit organization. BCSS is a nonprofit organization that provides hope, information, and emotional support to every person affected by breast cancer, beginning in 1993 and operations beginning in 1994. We've been around for quite some time, providing emotional support and any type of guidance, resources, and programming to breast cancer survivors right here, right now, in Berks County and Redding. So thank you so much for everyone watching this show, and we're excited to dive in. We've got a great guest today, Maleeva F. Epperson, who is a makeup artist that does our Face Up to Safe Beauty program. And you know, we always love working with Maleeva, and we're excited to talk to you about the programming we're gonna do this year and more. So I'll let you take the ring, Nina.
Let me tell you a little bit about Maleeva. She's a Redding-based freelance makeup artist, and she's been working in the industry for over 12 years. While her passion lies in film and television, she also enjoys offering one-on-one cosmetic and skincare consultations for women in business looking for a customized and easily duplicated routine. Other specialties that she has include bridal, print, boudoir, headshots, and competition makeup. Some of her past clientele include Tony Roberts, comedian, Princess Sora El Saud from Saudi Arabia, Blair Herter, a TV personality, celebrity motorhomes, the Travel Channel, and nationally ranked fitness competitors. In addition to her freelance career, she's a national certified trainer for Motives Cosmetics, and she's also a brand new mama. So welcome, Maleeva. We're glad to have you.
Hi, Maleeva. Oh, volume's a little.
You. Speaking of new mom, I do have him down next to me, and I'm hoping he stays that way. So
well, thank you so much for being here with us today, Maleeva. So to start off, can you tell us a little bit more about each program and session that's part of the Safe Face Up to Safe Beauty program, and just, you know, kind of inform the audience and the viewers of this show a little bit more about what we do with Face Up to Safe Beauty?
Yeah, absolutely. The goal of the Face Up to Safe Beauty campaign, I'm already starting to hear him. So hopefully you can't hear him on your end. But the whole goal about that was to provide education in a manner that just helps women take better care of themselves or take the time for themselves and lets them feel confident in routine that suits them. And so what's great about this series is we kind of wanted to start with the flow that talks about the inside, because the gut has such a great connection to beauty. And so we start there. And then from there we progress into skin, because there are three layers of our skin, and there's so many different, there's so much noise out there about what's good for the skin, what's not good for the skin, how to take care of it. And so the whole goal behind this is just educating on what are the steps when taking good care of your skin, and then what are some ingredients to look for in solid skincare that's very pure and very clean. And we get hands-on, so it's all about application so that every woman can leave feeling confident in creating their own routine at home. And so that's all about skin. And then from there, we move into actual makeup application. And so one of my favorites is a Beauty Basics workshop, which is basically the top 10 products that every woman should use in their beauty routine or in their kits. and then how to apply it so that no matter whether you have 2 minutes and you're putting your face on for the day, or you wanna take a little extra time and take 20 to 25 minutes to put your face on, you have a routine that suits your needs and you know how to use what you have. And so that was really the basics behind this series, is just creating that education for the everyday woman so that they feel confident recreating something that makes them feel great. And then we added a couple other workshops to the series, which is super fun. So we've actually inserted another makeup application that focuses on the holiday. And I believe that you have PowerPoints that kind of talk about each of these more specifically. And then one of my favorites that we just included this year is called a paint and sip. And so I think a lot of people have heard about the paint and sip parties where you can go and paint on canvas and have a glass of wine and create something, right? Well, we do the exact same thing, except we're painting the face, and that we're creating, I don't know if you can see this tower behind me, we're creating custom blended therapy foundations that right. everybody gets to walk with that day. And so it's just a little tweak on the paint and sip. Instead of painting canvas, we're actually creating something that we can put on our face.
Very cool. Thank you so much, Maleeva.
You're welcome.
Maleeva, what do you feel breast cancer survivors get out of participating in this Face Up to Safe Beauty program?
Oh, it's such a great question. I was really excited to serve this community, and there's a few different things. The biggest thing is education. And that's for every woman, but I think most especially for this community, because let's face it, you know, as we've gone through treatment and as we're on the other side, or no matter what phase you're in when in regards to your breast cancer journey, things change. Our skin changes, our insides change, our emotions change, like what we need to use in our house changes. And so we really wanted to be able to create workshops that, one, build an extra sense of community, because you're, and that's something that Breast Cancer Support Services of Berks County has been so incredible about, is creating a community and a culture for women to just come and be together and share in like minds and like experiences. And we're taking that same culture and we're just applying it to beauty. And so that there's the education behind, you know, what to use on our skin, what's the proper steps, based on how my skin used to be, but this is how it is now. How do I take the best care of it? How do I take the best care of my gut to ensure that, you know, I just feel incredible on my journey, no matter, you know, what phase I'm in that. And so I think that's what this series has done. And it's also promoting incredible ingredients and products. So it helps women feel very confident in what to look for when they're making their purchases and their choices about clean products to use. Because Nina, I know that was big for you. A lot of times, you know, as I'm trying to switch things up. And so it's just kind of taking that heavy lifting off of their shoulders and providing some direction. So they're not in it just trying to figure everything out themselves.
That is 100% the truth. You know, building community is very important, Maleeva. So thank you for emphasizing that. And thank you, Nina, as well. So Maleeva, how has presenting this program and working with survivors impacted you? You know, tell us a little bit more, even about the conversations maybe that we've had throughout the presentations, similarly to what you were just discussing with, you know, what you feel the survivors get out of the program, but also how has it impacted you personally?
Oh, I love that. It's from an impact standpoint, when I first, you know, moved to Berks County, I really wanted to create solutions for the everyday woman and create solutions for business women. That was like my direction when I started doing a lot more one-on-one consulting. But working with Breast Cancer Support Services has allowed me to step up my game as a professional, because one, it's a community of women that I'm excited to serve, that deserve to feel incredible and deserve to take care of themselves and more than just their health, right? So I've been really excited about that. But also it's helped me step up my game, like I said, as a professional, because I've gone to work in educating myself, not just in obviously like cosmetic and application and keeping that up, but I've made sure that I'm looking at ingredients that are super pure and super healthy, because I need to make sure that whatever I talk about is going to be great for this community of women. And so it's really helped me become intentional about what I use, where I'm stepping up my education and making sure that it's not just products and application that's great for women, but this specific community of women. And so I've been really excited. Like I said, it's just helped me grow as a professional, but also has really just helped me feel like I'm in alignment with where I'm meant to be serving right now. And that's been really special and fulfilling for me.
Love it.
That's great. Are there this next question is a two-parter, okay? Are there some products you recommend women should look at, but are there also a few products that we should stay away from as breast cancer patients in treatment, patients who are in recovery, have been surviving for years, or are lifelong fighters? Are there some things that we should or shouldn't use?
Yeah, that's a great question. And it's not just what's going on our skin and what we're using in our beauty routines, but it's really about what we're incorporating in our house and our atmosphere and what we're surrounded by. I mean, from a gut standpoint, you know, we want to make sure that we're staying away from filler ingredients. Because I know a lot of times we start looking for like supplements or multivitamins and things like that. And I always recommend, and even in our workshops, that anything that someone's looking to take, run by your healthcare professional, because they'll know the ins and outs on what pharmaceuticals you're taking and how things interact. But just looking at fillers, staying away from processed sugars from an internal standpoint, because those affect your skin and your health, and staying away from things that can cause inflammation in the body. From a skin standpoint, there's a specific ingredient that I like people to stay away from, and that ingredient's called bismuth oxychloride. It's found in a lot of mineral makeup, but the challenge is it's a very harsh ingredient that reacts to heat and can cause kind of reactions on the skin. And so that's something, it's just kind of a filler product that I like people to stay away from. And more so it's just about not necessarily everything to stay away from, but what to look for. Because we talk about, okay, the foundations of any great skincare routine is a cleanser, toner, moisturizer. And so we'll look at great ingredients that are for those three steps. And when it comes to what ingredients you're looking for is if you want to make sure they have the extracts of the botanicals instead of the essences. Because a lot of times fragrance or essences are what cause a lot of reactions, especially for sensitive skin. And so you kind of want to stay away from the fragrances and the essences and look for maybe the pure extracts of botanicals are very helpful. I know that's kind of a little all over place, but there's so much you can talk about, like what to look for, what to stay away from. One of my best recommendations would be to come to the class and to come to the different workshops so we can go a little more in depth in those.
Absolutely, most definitely. Definitely looking forward to Face Up to Safe Beauty starting very soon with our next session starting on June 2nd, which will be right here before we know it. So Maleeva, also, what are your future plans regarding providing more information to survivors about the importance of self-care and makeup, you know, and really big emphasis, of course, on self-care because, you know, as breast cancer survivors, it can be really difficult when they're first diagnosed, or even if they're 15, 25, 6 years out, you know, it can get really difficult. So, you know, if you could tell us a little bit more about, you know, maybe your own personal routine and how you apply that to the classes as well.
Well, I'm always looking to grow, and especially like as we all age, our needs change. So my needs from my 20s definitely changed to my 30s. My needs when I became a professional and working in a businesswoman changed. My routine now having a 6-week-old, I don't know if you can hear him in the background, he's very cranky, is now changed because I need to like start doing my makeup one-handed and keep it very short and sweet. And so, my own personal growth and what I need at different phases in my life is something that I'm looking to work into workshops. And what's neat about the education and the workshops that we have is we have kind of a curriculum in place, but that's not to say that it can't be malleable and change based on the attendees and the questions that they have. Because I always like to make sure that people come and leave with their questions answered, not just focus on just what the curriculum is. And so we have a lot of wiggle room when it comes to that. Something that I'd like to include more is bring in some more guest speakers that have different experiences in different areas, so that way we're constantly learning from, you know, women of all different shapes and sizes and experiences, not just me, because I'm not the end all be all of beauty education. And I'd also like to bring in a little bit more of how to implement self-care throughout your day, not just in your skincare routine or your beauty routine, but also certain things like, you know, listening to a good podcast, like putting your bare feet in grass for 5 minutes, like just going outside and experiencing sunlight for a few minutes. Like, there are different ways that we can incorporate self-care that I think a lot of women might not think about. And so I'd like to start incorporating little touches of that in our workshops as well.
Awesome. Great. Thank you, Maleeva. One of the other facets of this program, Face Up to Safe Beauty, we added on with our newly diagnosed survivor support group. And we expanded the program from 3 weeks to 4 weeks, because the fourth week is where we introduce this whole idea of safe beauty.
Yeah.
And
makeup, yep.
And the thing is we don't just talk about makeup or skincare alone. We have Tia Maisie, who is also a licensed cosmetologist, who will come in for this fourth week, and she will do a mini class, but she starts out with not just makeup products to look for, but body care.
Yeah.
Things to look for in shampoo, things to look for in body lotion, and ingredients to look for that are proven to be not healthy for you. And one of the facets of this fourth week is that we have been featuring a second makeup line called Mineral Fusion. And there are a number of great clean makeups out there. We tried to go for one that was easily available, but it was also EWG certified, which means it's certified by the Environmental Working Group, and they have to go through a number of steps to prove that they are environmentally safe for people to use. And Mineral Fusion has passed that, and they have an entire care line. They have shampoo, they have some body lotion, they have foundation, you name it, they have it. And one of the fun things that we do at this fourth program is that we have a kit that our survivors in that group can take with them. Now, what led to that was that American Red Cross used to do a face-up program also, but they're no longer very active in Berks County doing some of these programs. So BCSS tried to pick up the slack with that. And we pre-poll the women who are coming and ask them about different skin types and different allergies and things that they have, and then we put together a small sample pack, and Tia and I actually walk them through putting on a foundation, how to do it simply and safely, and things to talk about, like using a spatula instead of sticking your finger in your moisturizer, because that's one of the biggest ways of contaminating it.
Yeah.
And the thing that a lot of the women really like is the fact that many of them have gone through chemotherapy, and a lot of them lose their hair. And one of the biggest places that women feel sad about is their eyebrows, because that gives the shape to their face. So Tia will go to each woman, and she will make a template for each woman for their own eyebrows, which is something that they all seem to like, and then they get to take their samples home. And basically, what we're trying to do is introduce them to what Maleeva is going to be teaching them next. So we're trying to create a progressive program. The fourth week kind of hits everything. We give them a lot of resources and a lot of things, and then we come up with all these special dates, like Maleeva was mentioning, so which we'll talk about.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely. Well, thank you so much, Nina. And thank you again, Maleeva, for, you know, being here with us today and telling us a little bit more about the Face Up to Safe Beauty program. We love the name. We love everything you do with us. And again, also with Tia Maisie as well, two amazing makeup artists right here in Berks County that do a lot of phenomenal work with us at Breast Cancer Support Services. So I don't know if you wanted to say a last few words before we moved on to talking about the rest of the program, Maleeva.
It was my pleasure. Thank you so much for having me. I think, you know, this is such a special series that we've created. I love the collaboration with so many different professionals and women across Berks County. We're here to serve. And so the best thing is, like, please take advantage of these. Like these women are talking about, they're all complementary to the breast cancer community. So please engage with each other, engage with these workshops, come prepared to have fun, because that's what we're all about. And in the future, look forward to days where you'll actually be able to receive personal one-on-one consulting from me and whoever else might want to join me in that, where we'll actually set up times where women can come on for a little bit more of a one-on-one personal touch at the Breast Cancer Support Services office in Berks County. And so we're looking forward to all things to come. Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely,
thank
Maleeva.
You.
Well, thank you so much, and thank you, Nina.
You're welcome.
So moving forward a little bit, based off of, you know, the Face Up to Safe Beauty programs that we were all informing everyone about, like I mentioned earlier, on Thursday, June 2nd at 6 p.m. at 529 Suite C, Reading Avenue at Breast Cancer Support Services office, we will have our next upcoming program called All About Skin with Maleeva F. Epperson, our makeup artist that we had as a guest today on our Beyond Breast Cancer show. Feeling confident in choosing and creating a skincare routine. So that'll be our next workshop. So if you'd like to join us and you're a breast cancer survivor right here in Berks County, please RSVP or register by calling the office at 610-478-1447. Or you can email me at Raquel, that's R-A-Q-U-E-L, at bcssberks.org. And next up.
On Thursday, September 1st.
To point out that.
Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
Go ahead, Maleeva.
No, that's fine. I just wanted to point out, because I forgot to mention it, that women do walk home, away from that workshop with their own skincare collection that they can use at home. And so that's something that's really great. It's not just about the education, but you get to walk away with the tools and the products for you to be able to continue that routine and everything you learned at home.
Yes. Yes.
Absolutely. That's an important part, because it's all good to hear about it, yeah. But if you don't have the samples to try, you don't know what to do with it. So that's
exactly,
a big thing.
Exactly.
And a matter of fact, get your calendars ready for Thursday, September 1st, because that's our beauty basics. And Maleeva will talk about some of the top 10 products that women should own and proper steps and how to use them, because that's one of the things people always say, women say to me and say to us, well, I don't wear a lot of makeup because I don't know what to do with it. I don't want to look fake. I don't want to look like I'm painted. Well, trust me, ladies out there, you won't, because you'll feel good about what you're having and you'll feel good. And there is no pressure to buy anything. This is our gift to you as breast cancer survivors. We will never ask you to pay for anything at a program we offer you. This is part of our mission. So that takes care of September 1st. Hope you have it written down.
Absolutely. And then next up, part of the Face Up to Safe Beauty program will be Thursday, October 13th at 6 p.m. And that'll be a focus on custom blend and sip. So that'll be a really fun program. We'll have wine and snacks, you know. The wine is the fun part sometimes. But yeah, we'll have a very good time at custom blend and sip. So you can join us there for a makeup creation class where you'll be making up your own custom blend of makeup. Seating is limited again and registration is required. So please make sure to give us a call or email us in order to register for these programs. And next up.
That's me again. Thursday, December 1st at 6, we're going to do holiday makeup. Now, I know that we haven't gone very many places the last 2 years, so now we really want to. Yeah. I think everyone wants to get out a little bit. And so this will be a little bit of sparkle for something special. It'll be our last workshop of 2022. And it'll just give you some tips, again, on how to make your makeup a little bit more sparkly, a little bit more exciting for you, so that when you do spend a holiday and you just feel like you want to look just wonderful, this is the program for you. And again, that's December 1st at 6 p.m. and it is at our office. And again, you do need to register, either contact Raquel or email or call. We'll be all waiting for you and looking to have some fun again.
And a little bit of dates, a few dates that you can start saving and marking your calendar even more from June to July. So we have Arts on the Avenue in West Reading on Saturday, June 18th, that we will be at all day. So please join us, stop by our table, and come join us, take a selfie or two, and have some fun with us at Arts on the Avenue. Next up would be Steal the Glass Night on Wednesday, June 22nd at Willow Creek Brewing, West Reading, and the Pink Par 3 Party on Friday, July 15th. Rain Day will be Friday, July 22nd at the Maynard Golf Club. We're always looking for volunteers, so please join us.
And in September, we have the 8th annual Team Holly Hear Our Voices 5K. That takes place Sunday, September 11th at Grings Mill. And you don't have to be a runner. You can be a walker also to partake in that. Coming up then is West Reading Fall Fest on Saturday, September 17th on Penn Avenue, an outdoor event again, lots of fun. And on September 24th, again, a Saturday, we're going to have the third annual Classic Harley Poker Run, starting at Classic Harley Davidson. One thing I want to make sure I clarify, the 8th annual Team Holly was a Sunday in September. The other two events are Saturdays. So just want to make sure you have those dates again for September.
Yep, and then also for our annual 7th annual Pink Passion for Fashion Show, which will be taking place Sunday, October 2nd at the Reading Doubletree. So again, please join us for the Pink Passion for Fashion Show, annual 5K Holly Show, and many other events that we can use volunteers for. There's many ways to volunteer, donate, come, you know, participate in our resources and our programs, and come hang out with Nina, myself, Michelle, Vanessa, and everybody else part of Breast Cancer Support Services. Thank you for being part of Beyond Breast Cancer this morning with us, and we'll see you next month.
Beyond Breast Cancer on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Medical Society Alliance Incorporated.